Welcome everyone to today's lecture of transportation problem. Transportation problem is very important part of operation research. And my dear friends, I have uploaded some videos in Hindi, but I have deleted it due to some technical problem. But don't worry, I will upload those videos again in English. Okay. First, we will start with Northwest Corner method. Why we use this method, I'm going to tell you. Okay. But first, understand this transportation problem. Suppose these three are factories, okay, and these four are stores. Now try to understand these values given here. What does this indicate? These values here indicates the cost of transporting one good from factory 1 to store 1, from factory 1 to store 2, from factory 2 to store 1, from factory 2 to store 2, in this way. Let's talk about this value 18. What does this mean? That if you want to transport one good from factory 2 to store 2, how much it will cost? 18 rupees. Let's talk about this value. What is the meaning? If you want to transport one good from factory 3 to store 3, how much it will cost? 13 rupees. Let's talk about this value. 14. What does this mean? If you want to transport one good from factory 1 to store 4, it will cost 14 rupees. So these values are given are the cost of one item. Okay, one item. Cost of transportation of one item. Okay. Now, as an engineer, your job is to minimize the total cost. Okay, your job is to minimize the total cost. And to minimize the total cost, we will learn about three different methods, that is Northwest Corner method, least cost method, and Vogel's approximation method. But in this video we will talk about Northwest Corner method only. Another very important thing is that demand and supply. What is demand? Demand is the requirement of these stores. What is the total requirement or demand of this store? 200. What is the demand of this store? 225. What is the demand of this store? 275. What is the demand of store number 4? 250. Okay. Now, who will fulfill these demands? Of course, these three factories. What is the supply or rate of factory 1? 250. So, factory 1 can supply total 250 goods. Similarly, factory 2 and factory 3 can supply 300 and 400 respectively. Okay. But here we have learned, here we will take a very strong assumption, that is demand equals to supply. Whatever will be the demand, supply will be the same. Supply will not be one more or one less. Okay, suppose what is the demand here? Total demand I'm talking about. It is 950. Let's check that whether the supply is matching the demand or not. You add these three values, you will get 950. That means what? Demand is equals to supply. Okay. Suppose demand is 950, supply is 951. Then also you are fulfilling all the demands, but still your supply is one more. But we will not consider this case. We will consider that demand and supply will be exactly equal. Okay. But my dear friends, in real life, this may not take place, that demand is absolutely equal to supply. This assumption is taken place for the simplicity of the problem. Okay, now let's try to solve the problem. Why we are solving this problem? To find out the minimum value, minimum cost of this, minimum cost of transportation. Okay, total cost, what will we get? Okay, we will find out that. Let's use Northwest Corner method. So what Northwest Corner method tells is that, let me draw it in a different box. Okay, so I have made another box. Okay, now I will start the problem. See, Northwest Corner method, what does this mean? The name suggests about northwest direction. If this is north, this is south, it is east, and it is west. Northwest is this portion. Then in this box, which is northwest box, absolutely the first box. Okay, now we will start from here. Okay, try to understand. What is the total demand of the, we are in this box. First understand that what is the meaning of this box. This box means the relation between factory 1 and store 1. Okay. Now see, what is the total demand of store number 1? 200. And what is the supply? How much factory 1 can supply? It is 250. Now try to understand, if the demand is less than supply, then fulfill the demand. Then fulfill the demand. Okay. What I have said, you have understood. If the demand 200 is less than the supply 250, yes, it is less, then fulfill the demand. That means factory 1 is going to supply all the 200 goods to store number 1. Okay. Now, what is the demand of store number 1? It is 0 because it is fulfilled now. How much left with factory 1? It is 50. It has supplied 200. How much left is 50? Now try to understand. I am asking you one question. Will there be any good transported from factory 2 to shop 1 and factory 3 to shop 1? No. Of course no. So cross this box. Why no? Because the demand of shop 1 is already fulfilled. Okay. Now, northwest corner method says that come to this box. Just the adjacent box. Try to understand, what is the total demand of shop 2? 225. But this box means that you have to supply goods at store number 2 from which factory? From factory number 1. But can factory 1 supply all the 225 goods? No. How much it will supply? It will supply only 50 because it has got 50. It cannot supply more than 50 because how much goods were left with the factory 1? 50. But how much goods with are left with factory 1 now? It is 0 because 200 plus 50, it is 0 now. Now, try to understand. I will automatically cut these boxes. Why I will cut these boxes is very simple. Because I am not going to supply any goods from factory 1 to shop number 3 and factory 1 to shop number 4. Okay? Because factory 1 does not contains any more goods. Okay. Northwest corner method tells that now you come to this box. Okay. This box means you have to supply goods at store 2 from which factory? From factory number 2. Okay. Now check that what is the demand of store number 2? 225. But it is now 175 because 50 it has already got from factory 1. What is the demand? 175. And what is the supply of factory number 2? 300. What I have said before, if the demand is less than the supply, then fulfill the demand. So how much I will put in this box? Of course 175, because I will try to fulfill the demand. Now try to understand, how much is left with factory number 2? 300 minus 175, that is 125. You have understood. And what is the demand of store number 2 now? It is 0. So cross this. Why it is 0? Because 175 plus 50 is 225. Its demand is fulfilled. Okay. Now tell me, how much good factory 3 will supply to store number 2? Zero good. So cross this box, because the store number 2 is already, the demand of store number 2 is already fulfilled here. Why shall factory 3 supply any good to store number 2? Okay. Now, northwest corner method tells that up from this box you come to this box. Okay. What is the meaning of this box? This box meaning that you have to supply goods to store number 3 from where? Factory 2. Okay. Now, the question is, how many goods you can supply? Check that whether the demand and supply. What is the demand? 1,275. But how much factory 2 can supply? 125. Okay. So, what is the maximum value you can put here? It is 125. You cannot supply more than 125 goods to store number 3 from factory 2, because factory 2 contains only 125 goods. Have you understood? Its store number 3's demand is 275. But what to do? Factory 2 can supply only 125 goods. So it will supply all the goods it has. Okay, now what is the goods left? Zero. Now, what is the amount of goods factory 2 will supply to store number 4? Cross. Because it does not have any goods to give to store number 4. Okay, now you come here. Okay, this demand is fulfilled. Not fulfilled. How much more is left? 275 minus 125. That is 150. Store number 3 requires 150 goods more. Who will give this 150 goods? Of course, no other option. Factory 3 is going to fulfill its demands. So how much goods are left with factory 3 now? 250. 400 minus 150. Very simple. 250. What is the demand of store number 4? 250. Let's check that whether factory 3 can fulfill its demands. Yes, factory 3 has got 250 goods. So give it 250. So its demand is fulfilled. It is also fulfilled. And how much goods are left with factory 3? Zero goods. Okay. Now the most beautiful thing you will see is that all the demands are crossed off. That means what? All the demands are fulfilled. And all the supply becomes 0000. Because no more goods are left with factory 1, factory 2 and factory 3. Whatever goods are there in fact these three factories are transported to these shops. That's why their demands are fulfilled. Okay. You have understood this. Now the question is how to find total cost. It is very simple. One item cost is 11 rupees. How many items you have transported? 200. So 200 into 11. Plus, one item cost is 13. How many items you have supplied? 50. So 50 into 13. Plus, one item cost is 18. How many items you have supplied? 175 into 18. Plus, 125 into 14. Plus, 150 into 13. Plus 250 into 10. Whatever value you will get, it is your answer. It is the total cost of transportation. So this was all about Northwest Corner method. Okay. If you have any problem, then please comment in the comment section. Okay. I will try to help you out. And in the next video, I'm going to upload about least cost method. Thank you.